And to the woman and man that is watching us today, and those that are going to hear us today, through your word, Jesus, we believe that we are conquerors and victors, and more than conquerors, for the one that loved us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Nambi hallelujah.
Amen.
Ah. Obudde bulungi nyo.
It's such a good time that we have today.
Tugenda kuweleza Katonda.
We're gonna serve the Lord God.
Amanya ndobozi said David Mwesigwa.
David Mwesigwa.
For Soul Touch Healing Ministries.
For Soul Touch Ministries International.
Nze na mchala wange.
I together with my wife.
Timu yonaje tuli nayo.
Together with the team that we are with.
Tugenda kuweleza Katonda wafu.
We're gonna serve to our God.
Okuita moyo mutukufu.
Through the Holy Spirit.
Waliye yobwo bado wede mwa.
Whoever is there yet you had been weakened.
Olwalero tuze.
Today we have come with the word of God. The word that is going to bring back your hope. The word that is going to glorify the name of the Lord. And great right of all, we want you to know yourself. We are going right in the scriptures. In the book of Psalms. 139. From verse 1. This man. He's called David. But a time came and he got amazed of God. This Psalms is of an amazement to God. I believe that even you today, you shall be amazed of God. You still live today, not because you're so powerful, but there is someone that knew you. Whoever is watching us, please tell yourself that the truth is the man knows me.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Agamba bwati.
Thus says the Lord.
Asoka kugamba nti, Ayi Mukama.
Oh Lord.
Wammanya nze.
You have searched me.
Wammanya.
And known me.
Wulira ebigambo ebyo.
Listen to these words.
Ayi Mukama.
Oh Lord.
Wammanya nze.
You have known me.
Wammanya.
You have known me.
Chitegeza chewunya.
It means he's amazed of this.
Waliwo ensonga emwewunyisiza.
There is a reason why he's amazed of this.
Nakakasa ebigambo bino.
And he confirms these words.
Nasoka agamba nti, Ayi Mukama.
And he says that, Dear Lord.
Wammanya nze.
You knew me.
Sekyo kyokka.
Not only that,
naye wammanya.
But you have searched me.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Waliwo akumanya.
There is a God that knew you.
Waliwo akumanya.
And he knows you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ekyo nno kisanyusa.
That delights the Lord.
Abantu bangi balina enjogera egamba.
Many people have a kind of saying.
Nti oyo ayina abumanyi.
That she's known by someone.
Era wano mu Uganda abantu batera okugamba.
In Uganda they usually say.
Ebiseera bino babuuza ani akumanyi.
That these days they ask of who knows about you.
Bwe babanga abantu basobola okumanya.
If people can know you.
N'owulira ngu olina w'osobola okuyita.
And you feel you can have a way somewhere because you're known by someone.
Kikulu nyo nga Katonda yakumanyi.
It is so great when God knows you.
Kya muwendo munene nnyo.
It is very precious.
Katonda okubanga manyi.
For God to know me.
Bw'obeera ng'omanyiddwa Katonda.
If you're known by God.
Kitegeeza akuteekako amaaso.
It means he puts his eyes upon you.
Omuntu gw'omanyi.
A person that you know.
Bw'akuma essimu.
The moment that person calls.
Amanya gajja.
You shall get the names.
Bw'oba towulidde mannya.
If you've not seen the names.
Owulira eddoboozi.
You will hear the voice.
Bwe yeeyanjula.
When that person introduces himself to you. You will tell him, yes, I've known you.
Naye Dawudi agamba Mukama.
And that tells God.
Ayi Mukama.
That oh Lord.
Wammanya nze.
You knew me.
Si kyekyo kyokka.
Not only that.
Naye wammanya.
But you have searched me.
Waliwo ebintu ebitukakasa.
There are things that confirms to us.
Nti tuli bamanye ba Mukama.
That we are known by God.
Waliwo yatumanya.
There is a God that knew us.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Simanye gwali eyabadde atudde.
I don't know whoever is seated out there.
Waliwo ebintu ebimu.
There are certain things.
Nga tulabikanga abalekeddwawo.
We are like as if we are forsaken.
Tulabikanga abatamanyiddwa.
We are like as if no one knows us.
Tulabikanga abantu abatatulabye.
We are like as if no one has noticed us.
Nzize kugamba nti si kituufu.
I've come to tell you that it isn't true.
Kyangu abantu okwerabira.
It is very easy for people to forget.
Kyangu abantu okubanga tebakumanyi.
It's very easy for people to not
know you. Naye nzize kwogera mu linnya lya Yesu.
But I've come to speak in Jesus' name.
Oli awo.
Wherever you are.
Wotu dawo.
Wherever you are seated.
Waliwo omuntu akumanyi.
There is that someone that knows you.
Bamuyita Yesu Kristo.
And it's called Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Waliwo akumanyi bamuyita Yesu.
There is a God that knows you and it's called Jesus.
Katibwo wotu da walibadde okubira Katonda
mungalo. Where you seated you love for the Lord.
No mugamba koti nsanyuse kubanga omanyi.
And you tell him I'm so happy because you know me.
Mukama yebazibwe.
Hallelujah.
Laine eyokubiri negamba.
And verse 2 says.
Omanyi bwe ntuula.
You know my down city.
Era omanyi bwe ngolokoka.
And my uprising.
Ekyo nno kiraba ati.
That is also another thing.
Katonda akumanyi.
God knows you.
Bw'otuula.
How you sit down.
Ate amanyi ne bw'ogolokoka.
And he knows how you rise up.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bwe ntuula.
When I sit.
Amanya bwe ngenda okutuula.
He knows how I will sit down.
Bwe wali owuliddeko abantu nga bagamba abaana baabwe.
Have you ever heard any parent telling a child?
Nti mwana gwe ntuula yombi.
That I know your sitting manners are bad.
Eyo gye bayita entuula embi.
That kind of a bad sitting manner.
Wali wagimanyi.
There is someone that knows it very well.
Ate takomawo.
And he doesn't end there.
Amanyi ne bw'ogolokoka.
He knows how you rise up.
Yesu.
Jesus.
Line eddako egamba.
The next line says.
Amanyi okulowooza kwange.
He knows my thoughts.
Nga kukyalina wala nnyo.
Even when it's deep in me.
Ono nno omuntu akumanya bw'ati.
And this person that knows you to that extent.
Abeera akuli munda.
He's in the inside of you.
Nga naawe omuli munda.
And you're in the inside of him.
Nzize okwogera olwaleero.
I've come to speak out today unto the man and women that you have been like forsaken. There is a God that is inside of you. There is a God that you are inside in. The Bible has told us he knows how you sit down and he knows how you rise up. When you rise up, he knows your destiny. It means he knows us so deep. Whatever you're passing through today, maybe people might not know about it. People might not understand this. But there is a God that understands it. The Bible says, before we pray, he even knows the deep thoughts that we have. What we're gonna pray to him. I want to glorify God because he's our beloved. Before that thought is deep in the inside of you, he's the God that knows it. Today, what is troubling our life? In Jeremiah chapter 1, it says, and the Lord told Jeremiah that I have uplifted you and set you apart to be a prophet to the nations. And Jeremiah says, that I am a young boy. I can't even speak well. What will I say out? Before it was deep in the inside of him, what you will speak out and what you will do, our God knows it. For that reason, stop considering yourself like Jeremiah. Stop telling yourself that you're young. Stop considering yourself a poor person. Stop saying that I'm weak. The Bible speaks it expressly. But let the weak say, I am strong. If you're weak, rise up right now and say, I'm strong. Because the one that says it out knew you. And the one that says it out knew you. It means that even the poor should say that I'm rich. And the one that says it out knew you. If you don't speak it out, say, I will do. Because there is a God that knows me. Many people have discouraged you. They are trying to rob away all your hope. They tell you according to your family grounds, you cannot go any further. But there is a God that knew you. Before anyone can speak such words, there is a God that speaks something about your life. There is a God that speaks good about your life. There is a God that plans life for us. Before they plan your day, all the evil they want to do to you, all the evil what they speak about you, there is the so-called Jesus. He has thoughts about you and he knows the thoughts of God that are speaking evil about you, and what he's gonna do, he can disorganize all their plans because he has a good plan about your life. It has a good plan and a good thought about my life. Not of belittling me. Before the sickness attacks you, there is a God that thinks about you. He knew it when it was coming, and he knows how he will destroy you. For that purpose, there is no witchcraft to Israel. There is a God that does great things, that does powerful things. He's gonna do powerful things. Whatever the world thinks of you, it's not what the Lord thinks of you. There is an anointing here. changes the mindset of those that so the Lord wants us to rise up and feel very strong. I want to tell you, we can no longer
fight,
and we shall no longer fight.